My name is Jeff, and I'm from a small town in Virginia. When I was a kid, something crazy happened to me that you probably won't even believe. It all started when I was 10 years old. Me and my friend Rob were riding our bikes around our neighborhood like we normally did on the weekdays. We had just finished drinking our 2 cans of grape soda that we picked up from the mini mart, and we were happily hyped up on sugar. Rob and I then pushed the empty soda cans up against our tires to make our bikes sound like motorcycles. We both thought motorcycles were the coolest thing in the world, so we did this all the time. As we were riding our imaginary motorcycles around the block, one of our neighbors opened his door and started frantically walking toward us. I didn't even know this neighbor, and I'd only seen him outside a couple times since I moved here. He was a skinny man with long brown hair, and he looked like he was in his 40s. When he reached the road, he looked at us and said, "You two boys like motorcycles?" Me and Rob both quietly nodded, feeling confused and uneasy. He then said, "Well, come with me to my garage and I'll show you what a real motorcycle looks like." I told the man, "No thanks, it's getting late, we need to get home." The man frowned and said, "Okay, maybe some other time. I'm always here if you change your mind." He then walked away looking disappointed as Rob and I rode back home. The following week, I was riding my bike around the block again, but Rob was not with me this time. I started to approach the creepy man's house, and I noticed that his motorcycle was parked in his driveway, tempting me to stop by and get a closer look. I walked up the man's driveway and stared at the shiny new bike. And then, out of nowhere, the man's garage door opened. He walked out and said, "Hey Jeff, getting a better view?" I instantly felt creeped out because I never told the man my name. He then said, "You know, I'll take you for a ride on my bike right now if you want to see how it drives." I shook my head and told the man that I had to get home. And then, out of nowhere, the man grabbed my wrist and pulled me into his garage. My heart sank as I went into survival mode, punching and kicking at the man, while trying to scream and draw the attention of the neighbors. He then covered my mouth with the rag that he had in his pocket and told me to calm down, that everything was going to be okay. The last thing I remember was the garage door closing while everything went dark. I felt pure terror as I passed out, thinking I was going to die. I woke up in a daze, wondering where I was and what had just happened. I was now in a large bedroom with toys, a TV, video game systems, and a bed. There were no windows, so I immediately tried to open the door, which was locked. I shouted for help while banging on the door until the door unlocked and the man entered the room. He looked at me and said, "Oh, you're awake. Let me welcome you to your new home, Jeffrey. I've always wanted to have a son, and now my dream has finally come true." I looked at him like he was crazy and told him that I wanted to go home. He then replied, saying, "You are home, Jeffrey. You can have everything you want here. Just pretend that you're starting over. You can even call me Dad." I started to shake in fear as the man said, "It's all gonna be okay. You'll adjust to these new changes. You're going to be spending the rest of your life here, and we're going to have so much fun together." The man then smiled as he walked out of the room and locked the door. I started to panic, and a feeling of dread filled my whole body. I started to feel like I had no hope, and that my life was over. Thoughts raced through my head, flowing faster and faster until I couldn't take it anymore and began to cry. I started to wonder if the man was actually planning to kill me, or if he just wanted to keep me as a prisoner for the rest of my life. At that moment, I heard a bunch of noise, voices coming from outside the room. It was the police! I heard them kick down the door and subdue the man, who was yelling and screaming that he didn't know what was going on. The cops kicked down the door to the room that I was in and took me outside. I felt an extreme sense of relief as I was leaving the house, but I was still jittering from the shock and trauma of the whole situation. My family and Rob were waiting outside for me, and they hugged me tight, thankful that I was safe. They told me that one of the neighbors saw me get kidnapped through her window, and she immediately called the police. My parents took me home, and I went to sleep. Thankful I was back home, safe in my own bed. Looking back, I often ask myself, what would have happened if that neighbor didn't see me get kidnapped? It gives me goosebumps just thinking about it.